This log cabin comes with 40 acres, a huge upgrade from Kane and Lacey's gravel parking lot.
This property seems like it'd give me the best chance of getting that four-wheeler.
For sure. Wow, that's a huge, huge woodshed.
So the owners here have gotten by burning 5 cords of wood a year that they've cleared themselves.
So this is the primary source of heat for the house?
It is for them. There's also a propane heater, but they only use firewood from trees that have fallen down naturally in the woods.
To just pull all the wood right back here on that new four-wheeler I'm gonna get.
Oh my God, Ryan, what is this?
That's an outhouse.
I'm afraid to look.
There's a kid's seat so that we don't lose them out here.
Oh, that's something.
I don't know if anyone's really excited to use an outhouse, especially Lacey. And this one smelled terrible.
What's this bucket?
Looks like Lacey's new shower.
Yep, that's exactly what it is.
I almost thought it was a joke.
Alaskans come up with some creative solutions to everyday living, and this is one of them. This shower is a converted trash can with gravity-fed water. It's great in the summer, but not so functional in the winter when temperatures can hit 50 below zero.
You might have to get a high-pressure head installed.
Yeah. I'm still hoping that maybe on the inside there's a second bathroom, but I could always just shower at the gym. Wow, hon, I love the size of this wraparound porch.
The view is really nice from here.
Gorgeous.
We're really excited about the porch. It looks like something you'd see on a postcard.
So, of course, this house is off the grid. They provide their own electricity with this generator. They use 1/2 gallon of gas a day.
Well, that's not bad.
That's something we could probably handle.
Let's go in and check it out.
Right.
Wow.
Wow. This is a really nice space.
The wood stove's nice. It's right in the center of the house, so it probably keeps this place pretty warm.
There's one more little area here. They originally intended this space to be a bathroom. They built this house with it in mind that later on they would add in a water holding tank and a septic system.
There's no water.
That's right.
We would definitely try to get that turned into a bathroom as soon as possible.
Installing indoor plumbing and a septic system here would cost between $16,000 and $20,000. And Lacey may not be as ready to live without running water as she thought.
I did not think that living in the middle of Alaska, you could have a kitchen this nice. I guess the only downfall would be the water situation.
What do they do for washing dishes?
Basically buckets of water.
This kitchen is very impressive. Running water would make it perfect. I'm really anxious to see upstairs.
Take a look.
Quite the climb.
Ah, man. Yeah, it's a different type of stairway.
Not sure. I guess they have a gate there, so it would be safe for the kids.
So our kids like to wrestle around. We wouldn't want them falling off the ledge.
Upstairs, there's 500 square feet of space and a little Alaskan engineering to divide up the bedrooms.
Yeah. Seems like they just kind of used furniture to make walls. We'd probably, down the road, want to put up a wall so we could separate it into two bedrooms.
I'm just worried about the work that we'd have to put in to kind of make it the way that we would want it. It's going to depend on what the house costs.
The asking price for this house, $160,000.
Wow.
This house has been on the market for a while, so $160,000 is the asking price, but they would entertain offers.
We would definitely have to put indoor plumbing and shower. We could put in an offer lower, and that might help us make some of the modifications we'd like to make.